Good afternoon. Can I remind members that social distancing measures are in place in the Chamber and across the Holyrood campus? I ask that members take care to observe these measures, including when entering and exiting the Chamber, and please only use the aisles and walkways to access your seat and when moving around the Chamber. The first item of business this afternoon is time for reflection, and our time for reflection leader today is Reverend Andy Phillip, Chaplain, St Mary's Episcopal Cathedral, Edinburgh.
Presiding Officer, members and staff of the Scottish Parliament, it is an honour and a joy to lead you in this time for reflection, not least because for me, as a former official reporter, it's a homecoming of sorts. On Friday last week, the Church celebrated St Barnabas, a leader, though perhaps not a leading figure, in the early Christian movement. We know relatively little about him, although Barnabas certainly wasn't his real name. It was a nickname given to him by the 12 apostles, and it means son of encouragement. That name tells us a lot about Barnabas. For instance, when St. Paul, fresh from his conversion on the road to Damascus, tried to meet the 12 apostles, it was Barnabas who overcame their skepticism and made the introduction. It was also Barnabas who accompanied Paul on his first missionary journeys. Barnabas was there in the background, encouraging and supporting and shaping history. We all need others who support and encourage us. I'm sure such people helped shape your journey to the seats that you now occupy. And I can think of several who helped to shape my journey towards ordination. There are, of course, many people behind the scenes who support the functioning of the Parliament, who help you to shape history. Encouragement is not really the flavour of our culture. We Scots are a Guy Carnapshus Clan Jamfrey, and the sharply critical global atmosphere in which we live just ramps up the pressure of that tendency. Even if the sun sets on our anger, it doesn't so easily set on our tweets. At times, it seems that we are all more likely to scratch those we disagree with from our friends lists than to say, scratch that, to our outraged Facebook posts. Criticism is essential to the functioning of a healthy political system. We make no progress without proper scrutiny, but whether we are members of the Parliament, the public, or the punditariat, we must all remember that encouragement is at least as necessary as criticism, for encouragement feeds our growth as people and as a society. Like Barnabas, the encouragers are often in the background, but they too shape history and are remembered most fondly. I encourage you to value most not your moments of glory, but your hours of encouragement, to value being in the background and the people in the background, because to encourage is to love, and love is our highest calling.
Thank you, Reverend Phillip. Now move on to the next item. Point of order, Alex Cole-Hamilton.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I seek your guidance under the terms of Standing Order 7.3.2, which covers the conduct of members in this chamber. In a Scottish Government debate on Thursday, James Dornan stated his belief that the decision by Lothian Buses to suspend their services on the night of March 17th was motivated by sectarian prejudice against Irish Catholics on St Patrick's Day. Any Edinburgh MSP will tell you that Lothian suspended its services on the 17th after its drivers had suffered many nights of sustained abuse and violent attacks, including repeated stoning. Their decision was motivated by a desire to protect their staff and nothing more. made anywhere beyond the proceedings of this Parliament, Mr. Dornan's remarks might have constituted defamation against Lothian. As such, they cannot be allowed to stand. So can I ask you, Presiding Officer, what powers you have to compel Mr. Dornan to correct the record and apologise to both Lothian and this Parliament?
I thank the member for advance notice of this point of order. While the point of order mechanism has been used to raise questions about the accuracy of a contribution, it is not in fact a point of order. Members themselves are responsible for the accuracy of their contributions, and it is not a matter for this chair to rule on. But as the member knows, if he believes that inaccurate information has been provided, then there are a number of mechanisms available for that to be brought to the attention of the member concerned and, if appropriate, for the record to be corrected. I would take this opportunity to remind members about their responsibilities as elected representatives and invite them to have regard to these in contributions. They have a duty, members have a duty, to conduct themselves in a courteous and respectful manner.